Hi students, today we are going to discuss about general characters of fungi. Today we are going to discuss about general characters of fungi. Here you can see different types of fungus. First of all, we have to know what is fungi. Fungi are organisms that are grouped in a distinct kingdom. They are kept in a separate kingdom within the eukaryotes. Eukaryotes means the organism which is having true nucleus. So they are kept in eukaryotes. This kingdom include a diverse group of organisms ranging from microorganisms such as yeast or mold to large multicellular mushrooms. So fungi are a separate group, separate kingdom. Next, in short, they are avascular phylloid eukaryotic organism. Avascular means which does not consist of xylem and phloem. That means xylem and phloem are absent in fungi. Phylloid means which consists of a green shoot. The body is made up of tubular branched or unbranched filaments, which we are calling as hyphae. This filament is called as hyphae. A connected mass of hyphae are called mycelia. Mycelia, which is a spore bearing, they consist of spores. They are heterotrophic organisms. They produce extracellular enzymes and absorb the nutrients. And they use as a nourishment. They absorb nutrients. Heterotrophic means the organisms which derive nutritional requirements from complex organic substances. They are called heterotrophic organisms. Next, these fungi are eukaryotic organisms. They are neither plants or animals. They are neither plants nor animals. A heterotrophic organism means which is devoid of, which is lack of chlorophyll, that obtain nutrients by absorption, by the mode of absorption, these organisms, that means these fungi, get nutrients. They can reproduce by spores. Reproduction is by spores. The primary carbohydrate storage product of fungi is glycogen. Glycogen is the stored food material of fungi. Next, coming to the occurrence of fungi. The fungi are cosmopolitan in distribution, present everywhere, occurs in all possible habitats. They are cosmopolitan, present everywhere. Due to the absence of chlorophyll, they depend on other organisms for their food. They may be of saprophytes, parasites or symbionts. Saprophytes means the organism which depends upon, which decay, dead and decaying organic matter. Parasites means which depends upon other organisms. Symbionts means the mutual relation between the host and the fungi. They are called as symbionts. Most of the fungi are terrestrial, which grow in soil on dead and decaying organic matter. Next, coming to the kingdom. This fungi is placed in separate kingdom. They are called as kingdom fungi. Here you can see a separate kingdom is there. In six kingdom classification, plant A, animal A, fungi. These are the multicellular eukaryotic organism. It is the fungi are kept in separate kingdom. Fungi are heterotrophic. Fungi are achlorophyllous, heterotrophic, eukaryote, thallophytes. They are non-green in color with the capacity of live in all kinds of environment. They are generally feed on dead and decaying organic matter. Next, coming to the phyla of fungi. Phyla, Zygomycota. Zygomycota. It is called as bread mold. Example for this is Rhizopus. Black bread mold. It is called as black bread mold. Oomycota. It is called as water mold. Water mold. Potato. It causes potato blight disease. Phylum Ascomycota. It is known as sac fungi. Example yeast. Turfels. Next, coming to the phylum Basidiomycota. The club fungi. It is a club fungi. Example mushrooms. It also known as smut, rust fungi. Phylum Dutiomycota. It is known as fungi imperfecti. Next, here you can see the structure. This it comes under fungi, comes under eukaryota. They are divided into Jagomycetes, Basidiomycetes, Ascomycetes, imperfect fungi. Next, coming to the characteristics of fungi. Fungi are not plants. They are not come under plants. They are separate kingdom. They are not photosynthetic. They are, they doesn't consist of a chlorophyll. They are achlorophyllic organism. They are eukaryotes. They are non-motile. Most of them are saprophytic. They live on dead and decaying organic matter. The cell wall is made up of chitin. The cell wall of fungi is made up of chitin. They are heterotrophs. Heterotrophs means the organism which depends upon the other organism for their food materials. Major fungi are decomposers. Body is made up of long filamentous hyphae which forms a mycelium. Reproduction can be done by sexual and asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is by spores and sexual reproduction is by mating of hyphae filaments. Okay? Reproduction will be two types, sexual, asexual. Sexual by spores, asexual by filament mating. Coming to the cell wall, they are made up of chitin, which is a complex polysaccharide. This body is called as, here you can see the thallus. Thallus is nothing but the body of fungi is called as thallus. They grow as microscopic tubes or filament called hyphae. They grow as microscopic tubes or filaments called hyphae. Here we can see the functions of cell wall. They protect against osmotic lysis. The cell wall of fungus protect the fungus from osmotic lysis. They act as a molecular sieve. They contain pigments for the protection of the fungi. This cell wall also helps the fungi for binding site of the enzymes. Next, coming to the cell wall composition. These are two types of cell walls. One is primary cell wall, another is secondary cell wall. The primary cell wall is made up of a chitin. The secondary cell wall is made up of chitosans. The primary cell wall consists of a glucagon. Glucagon as a polymer of beta glucose. This chitosan, it is also the secondary cell wall is also consists of a amorphous glucagon and pigments like melanin, lipids, proteins and enzymes. The primary cell wall consists of a chitin. The secondary cell wall consists of chitinosan. Okay? Next, the absorptive heterotrophs. These are also known as the fungi. The main character is absorptive heterotrophs. That means they digest the food first, then they absorb it into their body. They are known as absorptive heterotrophs. That means they digest the food, they engulf the food first. Whatever the food they get, they first engulf the food, then they absorb it into their body very slowly. They release digestive enzymes to break down organic matter into simple substance. The stored food material energy is glycogen. Next, here you can see the structure of fungi. Here it is a rhizopus. Here you can see the structure, spores, sporangia, rhizoids, stolon, and like here basidium, fruiting body. Here it is a fruiting body, mycelium, hyphae. This is the structure of fungi. Next, these fungus, they are mainly decomposers. Fungus are mainly decomposers and the recycling of the nutrients in the environment. They mainly causes recycling of nutrients in the environment. Most of the fungi are multicellular except unicellular yeast. They lack true roots, stem and leaves. This fungi does not consist of any roots, stem or leaves. Here you can see the unicellular and multicellular fungi. Some fungi are internal or some fungi are external parasite. They may be internal parasite, some may be of external parasite. A few fungi act like a predator and capture prey like roundworm. Here you can see predaceous fungi feeding on the nematodes, platyhelminthes, nematyhelminthes, roundworms. Here you can see. Next, they can be reproduced by sexual and asexual reproduction. So the reproduction is by sexual and asexual reproduction. Here you can see some of the edible fungi. Edible fungi means which you can take as a food, and some are poisonous fungi. Next, coming to the hyphae. The hyphae, it is a tubular shape, one continuous cell filled with the cytoplasm or nucleus. It may be a multinucleated. It consists of a hard cell wall made up of chitin. It is also known as exoskeleton. Next, coming to the stolons. Stolons are the horizontal hyphae that connect group of hyphae to each other. Next, coming to the rhizoids. Rhizoids are the root-like parts of the hyphae that anchor the fungi, that supports the fungi. Here you can see. Next, coming to the septae. The cross wall is called as septae. The cross wall is called as septae. Septae may be in the form of compartments. The cell is divided into small compartments. It is called as septae. Septae has pores for the movement of cytoplasm. They form a network called mycelia. These mycelia runs through the thallus. Thallus is nothing but the body of fungi. Fungi get carbon from organic source. Tips of hyphae releases enzymes. The enzymatic breakdown substance produced diffuse back into the hyphae. So the enzymatic breakdown of substrate product diffuse back into the hyphae. Here you can see the nucleus direct the digestive process of enzymes are released. Next, modification of hyphae, different types of hyphae. Fungi may be classified based on the cell division. They may be with or without cytokinesis. They may be aseptate or cenocytic. Aseptate means without septate. Without septate means there is no division of cell. Here you can see the diagram. So that is called as aseptate. Septate means with septa. That means there is a partition of the cell. The cell will be partial. Next, coming to the reproduction. Reproduction may be sexual and asexual. Most of the fungi reproduce asexual and sexual reproduction by spores. Asexual reproduction is most common method and produces genetically identical organism. Fungi reproduce sexually when conditions are poor and nutritional scarcity will be there. Then only it undergoes sexual reproduction. Now we are discussing about sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is done when there is a poor lack of nutrients. So the fungi will undergo sexual reproduction when there is an unfavorable condition. Here there is no female or no male fungi will be there. Some fungi shows dimorphism. Some fungi may show dimorphism. They may grow mycelium or yeast in 25 degrees centigrade. They look like a filamentous shape. At 37 degrees centigrade, the yeast is in the form of round. Haploid. In hyphae, haploid one and hyphae from two mating types plus minus fused for fertilization form a hyphae with two nuclei that become a zygote. Plus haploid minus haploid fused together and form a zygote. The zygote divide to make a spores. Here you can see plus minus fused together and forms a zygote. These are the spores. So here we are discussing two different methods of reproduction. One is homothallism. Homothallism, it is a sexual reproduction. In this, two haploid nucleus derived from the same individuals fused to form a zygote. That means one individual gives male and female. So fused together and form a zygote, and then they undergo meiosis. Example for this is Aspergillus. Self-fertilized unisexual reproduction. It is also homothallism is also called as self-fertilized unisexual reproduction. Coming to the heterothallism, here species have sex that reside in different individuals. The term is applied particularly to distinct heterothallic fungi which requires two compatible partners to produce sexual spores from homothallic ones, which are capable of sexual reproduction from a single organism. in heterothallic fungi, two different individual contributes nuclei to form a zygote, whereas the homothallism only one organism. Here two individuals contribute nuclei to form a zygote. Example for this is Saccharomyces cerevisiae, Aspergillus fumigatus, Aspergillus flavus, Penicillium species, Neurospora. There are three types of asexual reproduction. Coming to the asexual reproduction, there are three types of asexual reproduction. One is fragmentation, other is budding, and the third mode is spores. Fragmentation, the part of mycelium becomes separated and begins a life of its own. So that is called as fragmentation. Next, coming to the budding, a small cell forms and gets pinched off it. It grows into full size. Example is asexual reproduction can also be done by spores by a single mycelium. Next, I'm coming to the fruiting bodies. Fruiting bodies are modified hyphae that makes asexual spores. An upright stalk is called as sporangiophore, support the spores. This sporangiophore, from the sporangiospores, the spores can be come. This is the asexual reproduction by spores. The spores are formed. How the spores are formed? Directly on the hyphae, inside of the sporangium on the fruiting body. The spores are present inside of the sporangium. Spores are adaptation to life on land. Ensure that the species will disperse to new location. The spores can be spread through air. So the new locations, the spores can be spread. Each spores containing a reproductive cell that form a new organisms. They are not wanted. They can be dispersed by wind. Next, coming to the classification of fungi based on the nutrition, they are saprobes, that means saprophytic organism, which depends upon the dead and decaying organic matter. They are called as decomposers. Saprophytic is decomposers more than mushroom. Some may be parasites, they may be harmful, harm host, and some may attack to the plants. Example for this is rust fungi, smut fungi. Some may be act as a mutualist. Mutualist means work, mutual association between the host and the fungi. Example for this is lichens, mycorrhizae. They give the benefit. Both the organs will get benefit. Next, some of the major group of fungi. Basidiomycota, they are known as club fungi. Jagomycota, they are known as bread molds. Critomycota, they are known as critics. AM fungi, they are known as mycorrhizae. Ascomycota, they are known as sac fungi. Lichens, they are known as symbiosis of algae and fungi. Some of the examples of fungi, Puccinia, are generally known as rust fungi. Puccinia, these are known as rust fungi. It consists of 700 species. They are the parasites on plant. They affect on wheat, coffee, and beans. The internal obligate parasite, the Puccinia, it is a fungus, it is an internal obligate parasite. It is a plant pathogen. They are generally heterogeneous, require two hosts to complete its life cycle. Here you can see the classification. It belongs to the class Basidiomycetes and family Puccinia. Next, coming to the yeast. Yeast also comes under fungi. Yeast grow by budding. Here you can see the yeast can grow by budding. Yeasts are present almost everywhere. So here you can see the budding yeast. Next, coming to the uses. What are the uses of fungi? Fungus can be edible. Edible means which are suitable to eat. Example, truffles. Truffles are the type of fungi that grow underground and can be eaten. Morels. Morels are a widely distributed edible fungi which has a brown oval or pointed fruiting body with an irregular honeycomb surface bearing spores. So these are edible fungi. Some are antibiotic producing fungi. Example, Penicillium. Penicillium mold, which is an antibiotic producing fungi. Next, some are flavoring, good flavor producing fungi. They are used in the preparation of cheeses. Some fungi like Saccharomyces cerevisiae used in the food making, example bread making and wine and beer making industries. Next, they are also useful in ecosystems. ecosystem relationship, basidio mycota, are very important for the ecosystem and for humans. They act as a decomposers. Many basidio mycota, which is the largest floating bodies, are common and important agent of wood decaying or decomposers of leaf litter, animal dung. So they decomposes all the waste materials. Next, it uses in the decomposes of waste, many saprophytic fungi decomposes plant animal debris and continuously remove from the man's environment. They remove dead and decaying plant particles, animal particles from the man's environment. During this process, they also liberate a large amount of CO2, which is used by the green plant for the synthesis of food by process called photosynthesis. Next, decomposition of organic waste also result in the formation of humus, which is needed for the growth of plants. So these are the useful for the ecosystem. Coming to the edible fungi, there are about 200 species of fungi which are used as a food. Edible fungi means the fungi which can be taken as a food. The most important among them, commonly called as mushrooms, Agaricus campestris, puff balls. They will look like a puff balls. They are very high nutrients, highly proteinaceous food material, proteins and high resource of vitamins. They are also very delicious in taste and regarded as a delicious of table. Next, coming to the symbiotic relation, some also plays an important role as a symbiotic relationship, such as mycorrhizal association with the roots of plant, whereby the fungus receives carbohydrates from the plant, photosynthesis, and the plant gains the mycelium's very large surface area to absorb water and minerals, nutrients from the soil. Mycorrhizal association, the symbiotic association of fungi and the root of the higher plants, is called as mycorrhiza. Literally meaning of mycorrhiza is fungus roots. There are two main kinds of mycorrhiza, ectomycorrhiza and endomycorrhiza. In case of ectomycorrhiza, the fungi completely encroach the rootlets in the sheet. The hyphae penetrate only between the cells of the root cortex. In case of endomycorrhiza, the fungi does not form external sheet but lives within the cells of the root. They are called intracellular. Mycorrhizal roots generally lack root hairs. This association helps in the absorption of nutrients. The mycorrhizal roots are generally resistant to infection. The yeast can be used in the preparation of cakes. The large scale production of yeast cake is called microbial farming. They are prepared by mixing a large number of yeast cells with some inert substance such as starch, and then they compress to form a cake. Yeasts are rich in protein, and hence the yeast cakes are eaten directly as healthy giving food. Yeast cakes are extensively used in baking and brewing industries. They are also used in laboratories to demonstrate fermentation in sugar solution. Some of the beneficial effect of the fungi: they act as a decomposers, that means nutrients and carbon recycling. Biosynthetic factories can be used to produce drugs, antibiotics, alcohols, acids, food. They are also example fermented products and mushrooms. They are used for genetical studies. They are used for production of vitamins. They are used for production of hormones. Some may be edible fungi. Fungi also used in the production of insecticides. These are the usefulness. Next, coming to the harmful effects of fungi. Harmful effects of fungi: they helps in the destruction of food. They helps in the destruction of food, paper, cloth, and some of the luvar means disused articles such as furniture. They mainly destruct the food particles. Luvar, mainly furniture, they spoil the furniture, paper, and cloth. They causes plant diseases like smut disease. They also possess animal disease. They also possess human disease, including allergy. The toxins produced by poisonous mushrooms, they affect the intestinal disorders. Next, summarizing of general characters of fungi. Fungi are found in all types of environment where organic matters are available. For example, water, air, dead and decaying organic matter, and living organism. Some fungi are unicellular. The thallus of the fungi is long and tubular with the filamentous branch called as hyphae. The hyphae are aseptic, coelocytic, uni or multinucleated. The mass of interwoven hyphae is called as mycelium. Mycelium may be unicellular or multicellular. The cells of fungi have definite cell wall which is made up of chitin. The chitin is a nitrogenous material containing polysaccharides. The chitin is nothing but a polysaccharide. Other components of fungal cell may be cellulose, glycogen, cellulose combined with the glucagon. Like that, it may be a chitinogen, chitin, melanin. These are the some other components in the cell wall. The fungi are eukaryotic, but they do not have any plastids. As fungi do not have chlorophyll, they cannot perform photosynthesis. They cannot prepare their own food material. They obtain their nourishment from the environment by extracellular digestion and absorption of digested food material. So they are known as heterotrophs. Heterotrophs are the organisms which depends upon other organisms for their nourishment. Fungi are saprophytes. They depend upon dead and decaying organic matter as parasite or inside of the living organism. They may be saprophyte, they may be a parasite. Saprophytes means which present on dead and decaying organic matter. Parasites means which present inside or outside of the host. Some fungi grow in symbiotic relation with algae and form lichens. Some of the fungi grow in close association with the roots of the vascular plants, forming mycorrhiza. The reserve food material of fungi is glycogen. The fungi reproduce vegetatively by fragmentation, budding, and fission. During the favorable condition, they reproduce asexually by spores. The asexual spores are called sporangiospores and conidia. The sporangiospores may be zoospores or aplanospores. Zoospores are flagellated spores with one or two flagella. Aplanospores are non-flagellated spores. Okay, this is about asexual reproduction. Coming to sexual reproduction, sexual reproduction in fungi is through gametes and is carried out with the help of planogametic copulation, gametangial contact, gametangial copulation, spermatogenesis, or somatogamy. Fungi shows progressive reduction of sexuality. Fungi exhibit asexual, haplotrophic, haplotrophic, dikaryotic, haplodiplontic, or diplontic reproduction. Okay, that's all about the general characters of fungi. Okay, thank you.